Everybody, today's session is about ankle strengthening exercises which are helpful after ankle sprain. Ankle sprain is one of the most common problems that usually happens in athletes and usually young people, mostly which they are active. Sometimes they go to hiking, rock climbing, and sometimes during the sport injury. Usually what happens is ankle rolls. Ankle joint is not designed to roll all the way. As we said, it can a little bit supinate and a little bit pronate, but it cannot really supinate or pronate too much because the ligaments over here in the medial side and lateral side, these are supporting the ankle from not rolling. And if it rolls more than certain amount, this ligament has to overstretch or even tear to let that happen. So what's happening is when we have an ankle sprain, we're gonna damage these ligaments most likely, sometimes for the long time and sometimes even forever. Some people go to the surgery to repair this ligament, but most of the time this ligament can heal by themselves. Or even if they don't heal fully, we have to strengthen the muscle around it and try to get the balance and everything back for the patient for being able to resume the normal life. Sometimes the athletic and sport activities can get affected for a long time and we have to work a lot until get them back. Especially for people that they have deformities, as we talked about. Deformities such as forefoot, pronation, overpronation, which is foot like this, or people that have flat foot, arch falling, or people that have high arch. These are the people that are more prone to ankle sprain, especially people with the flat feet, they are more prone to ankle sprain, and we're gonna tell you why. Usually the ankle sprain, what happens during the sprain is people usually over supinate. They go like that. And you know, the adductor foot. So what happens, the ligaments in the outside, which is between that fibular bone and the talus bone, the big bone of the ankle, gets tear or overstretched. What you can see here, if you can see in the picture, you see the ligaments in here, and you see how they understretch when the ankle rolled, and that shows the tear on the ligaments. I can try to help you a better, more obvious picture also, which shows a lot of ankle sprains. Best thing that you should know when your ankle sprain is, you're gonna have a lot of inflammation and edema. So you can recognize the ankle sprain by a lot of edema and inflammation. Usually gets purple. And it's very common to get a lot of inflammation when you have an ankle sprain. So that will look like this, most likely. So it gets black and blue, big. You're not gonna be able to see that malleolus, which is the little bone in here, which you're usually supposed to see it. That if you have a bad ankle sprain, maybe it's a tear in the ligament or it's overstretch of a ligament, you're most likely not gonna be able to see that bony anymore because everything is puffy and inflamed on that area. So what happens, you're gonna get a lot of pain, a lot of inflammation, and you even cannot put the foot on the floor. It may look like something like that, which is very severe. So if that's the case, you can go to the doctor first, make sure you do the x-ray. If it's not the fracture, sometimes the bone can get fractured also if it's really bad. But most of the time the bones are not affected, but sometimes they are. If it's a bone affected, then that's a different story. Then it's a fracture, you most likely have to go to the surgery room. They're gonna fix it with the pins and screws, and then, or even the plates if it's really bad, the metal plates, and then they're gonna put you in the cast for a little while, and then if later on is not the device is not proper, they may take the device out, or you may live with that device for the rest of your life inside your body with the metal. if it's not a fracture, if it's an ankle sprain, sometimes, most of the time it heal on its own, it doesn't need surgery, unless if it's really, really fully damaged ligaments and very unstable foot, then they might want to do the repair ligament surgery, which is not too common. They still have to probably put the devices and stuff inside your ankle. But sometimes it can heal by itself, even if it's a fracture, if it's non-mobile fracture, but it has to be in cast for a long time. The problem with being the limb in the cast for a long time is always you develop a lot of scar tissue, a lot of tightness. You might lose a lot of range of motion. Sometimes even you lose the range of motion forever. You, even with the physical therapy, you're not going to be able to get all the motion back fully. Sometimes you're going to have a limited motion for the rest of your life. But most of the time, if it's this, not too severe, physical therapy can help. The first day of the ankle sprain is really important for you not to do too much movement. You have to put them, put ice on your ankle for a long time, maybe for 10-15 minutes, and then keep doing the ice maybe up to even 5 times or more than 5 during the day. And you can elevate your ankle, put it somewhere that's higher than your heart, because the foot's always hanging down and all the blood goes down there. So that's why it can get very inflamed and puffy. And all the inflammation later on can turn to the scar tissue. If you don't control the inflammation on time, then inflammation stay there for a long time, and that can cause a lot of scar tissue later, which the edema turns to scar tissue, and then you're gonna have lack of range of motion for the rest of your life even. So you have to control that extra inflammation in the first days. That's very huge. So put the ice, put elevated higher than your heart, so the blood and liquid can go back to your system, to your blood and lymphatic system, and then you can process that liquid so it don't get there and then cause the edema and the scar tissue later. And then another thing you can do the compression. Compression means that you have to have a band, even ACE bandage on, which they can help you with bringing down the swelling, so on the ankle. If you can bring down the swelling in maybe a week or so, or even less than a week, then you can have a hope that later on you're not gonna have a lot of scar tissue. That's the first thing that you deal with, so not letting it get too inflamed. But certain amount of inflammation is always necessary for your body. Body have that inflammation as a weapon against the injury. So when something gets injured, it means that something partially torn or something overstretched and bleeding inside or something happening, then you need a lot of cells to come and help to heal that tissue, right? Especially for fracture. As you know, fracture is famous for having a big swelling. So why? Because bones are very active, full of cell tissues. So you can, when you have fracture on the bone, a lot of inflammation happens, meaning that a lot of cells released and coming to play to help to give enough circulation to the area to start healing. But if that inflammation gets too much, it's a problem. So too little inflammation and too much inflammation, both are problems. That's always famous in physical therapy. We have to have a right amount of inflammation to help the healing and at the same time prevent the later on scar tissue. So that's the first day of after sprain. So if you really get rid of the extra inflammation and now you're dealing with the pain and all of the weakness and instability and motion problems, then we coming to play to help you. Usually people after a sprain, they are in a boot for a certain amount of time based on what doctor diagnose. So if a person is in the boot, the only thing we can do, we can just have them move their fingers. So moving the toes that are out of the boot for a little bit. So wiggling the toes, basically, that's the most important thing. Moving the knee, moving the hip, doing all kind of stretches in the knee and hip and toes until the ankle is ready to get off the cast and we can start working on it. The first thing usually that we work on it is the active range of motion. You need to know that sometimes even that movement, which seems to be very easy, that dorsiflexion, plantar flexion, is a challenge for people after ankle sprain. So it's gonna be very painful and even limited. So you're gonna do this and that, but you better doing it higher than than your heart. So maybe you can lay down somewhere, call it ankle pump. What you're gonna do, you're gonna put it somewhere higher and then you keep moving it. This is ankle pump, right? Very important to do these exercises somewhere that are not too low, because if it's too low, then as we said, the inflammation is not gonna get better and it gets inflamed. So the next thing you do is ankle circles. You're gonna make a circle like that. Okay. You can do abduction, adduction. That's huge. You gotta do that. Okay. It might be a little hard to do the supination and pronation, because supination and pronation is usually what happens during the sprain. That's the mechanic of injury. So that might be very, very aggravating for the ligaments. So you can skip that one. So up and down, right and left a little bit. If it's right and left painful, forget that one too. Just don't do it too much. And then you can do ankle circles. After you get a little bit better, you can do what we call it ankle alphabet. So basically you have your ankle still a little higher than your body, and then start drawing A, B, C, D. That can give you opportunity to move ankle in all different motions possible and make sure that your range of motion is preserved. So these are the very important specific exercises you can do at first after you get the cast off. So these are active range of motions basically. You're not gonna put your weight on until your doctor lets you put your weight. Sometimes doctor says the partial weight bearing, sometimes it's a full weight bearing. If it's a partial weight bearing, it means that you gotta put, when you're in the like boot, you gotta put a little bit of your foot there, or sometimes it's a toe touch feet bearing, and you can do toe touch and walk with probably with the crutches. Usually that happens with the crutches. If it's a partial weight bearing, you can do a little bit with the crutches, not too much. But if it's a full weight bearing, then you're ready to start walking and you can take the crutches off, of course. Basically, when you take the crutches off and you have your limb ready for therapy, then one of the most important things for you is to strengthen that movement that are damaged and are weak. So what you can do, you can grab a elastic band, put a loop in there, put it in your foot, put the loop on your foot, and what we do, we pull it and do plantar flexion against it. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you can see, that's one of the movements that's important for us to get back. Okay, that's plantar flexion. And then you can do dorsiflexion. You have to just put your other foot on top of the band and then go against it like this. Very easy. For going out, which is abduction, you can go a little bit more space and then make sure your heels are on the floor and you're not moving your knee. You can put your hand on the knee to stabilize your knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that's the third motion. The fourth motion is going inside or adduction. So what we're gonna do, we can put this leg, the non-injured leg, on top of this and make a crisscross. And then we put the heel of the injured leg on the floor and we go against that pressure inwards. Right? Making sure the knee is not moving. The good thing is I have the foot on top of it, so I don't let the knee move. So I know that all the movement is coming from the ankle now. Right? These are most important strengthening exercise for you. You have to do this. Band is a good investment again for you, so you can do this for the long time after after your ankle sprain, until you get ready for the weight bearing exercises, which exercises in standing. And then you can start doing some exercise in sitting. Though sitting is a partial weight bearing, is not a problem, so you can do dorsiflexion. frontal flexion and sitting. After you get ready for standing, what you can do, you can hold on to something. I'm gonna hold on to the chair, and then you can do with both leg frontal flexion and then dorsiflexion. Okay, whenever you're ready to go to the next level, you can do single leg plantar flexion and single leg dorsiflexion. They are very tough exercises. We usually save them for the last. Usually that, when you do this, is usually more than 8 weeks after the injury. So you're really good. So you can do single leg already. You can definitely walk on your toes. That's gonna be a very advanced exercises. To strengthen plantar flexion. Walk on the heels, strengthen dorsiflexion. You can definitely start doing the little bit of the supination, which we told you the supination is gonna be the aggravating, because usually the mechanism of injury of the sprain is like that. So you already have damage of a ligament, it might be painful. Don't go too much, but do it and hold it. And you can do pronation. Okay. So supination, pronation, and then you can walk in supinated position. Walking in the supinated position. Walking in a pronated position. Depending on what kind of deformity you are more prone to, if you have you are having flat foot and you're more prone to do the overpronation, you might want to do focus on more supination walk and supination exercises like that. But if you're more having the hypercurvature or you have high arch and you are more prone to do the supination, so you might want to do more of a pronation. Okay? Down the road, we usually start feeling that we have a calf tightness, so we have to do the calf stretches. That's one part of the plan, definitely. As I told you, we have different calf stretches. You can get on top of something. Again, I'm gonna repeat myself a little bit from the last video, stretching the calf. You can do stretch the calf with the knee straight, which is more gastrocnemius stretch. And then you can put the gastrocnemius in a slack and do the soleus stretch with the knee bend while you dorsiflexing your foot and holding it for 30 seconds. Or again, you can use a wedge, which I have it, so I use it. If you don't have it, that's fine. You can use it in the edge, don't worry about it. And you can, of course, do the lunges, which I already showed you. So these three ways of stretching the calf muscle is always helpful. Sometimes you need to stretch the front too. The muscle in the front gets too tight. You can stretch the dorsiflexors by doing that. Okay. And the last section is we have to check the balance and gait for the people. Balance and gait means that walking and balance is part of the issue that usually happens for people that get ankle sprain. So if we have ankle sprain, we usually lose the balance. So the best exercise, we're going to start standing on one foot and trying to get our balance. As simple as that. If you can't do it first, you can use the other foot, toe tip on the floor and try to do that. Okay? And later on, you can add some uneven surface and do that on top of the uneven surface, like the cushion or something. You can try to do that. If you have to put again the toe tip on the floor, do it. If not, do this. Next balance exercise will be standing in tandem, one leg in front of the other one, and hold it for 30 seconds. Then you can stand this way, change your legs, stand tandem like that. Then you of course can stand tandem on top of the uneven surface like this. And you can change the tandem stance like this. And you can walk in tandem. So you walk like you're walking when the cop gets you if you are on a drunk driving ticket. Hopefully you don't have one. So, and you can go backwards too. Why working in the balance? Because these ligaments in the ankle, they are responsible for what the sensation they call proprioception. Proprioception is the sensation of the movement, so then the position of the foot and position of a limb on the space. If you lose that ligament integrity in outside or inside, you're not going to be able to balance yourself good because your ligaments cannot have a good sensation of where the foot's in the space and what's the foot position, so you can recurrently sprain your ankles more and more. So people that sprain the ankle, usually they say, oh, we got that again, we got that again. So it keeps happening to me, I don't know why. And we know why as a physical therapist, because the ligaments are not trained enough to get the proprioception back and get the balance back. If we don't have that balance back, so we can have what we call recurrent ankle sprain, which keeps happening and happening and happening. And every like 6 months or every 1 year, every year or every couple years, people have the limb inside the boot. It keeps happening to them and they said, oh, I'm not lucky, it keeps happening to me. It's not about the luck, it's about how we train the ligaments after the ankle sprain. And of course, it's about the arch of the foot. People with the low arch, especially with the flat foot, they have more tendency to get ankle sprain, because they are the overpronating, the foot intrinsic are very weak, the ligaments are already overstretching, the plantar fascia is overstretching, so they don't have enough stability of the foot. They have what we call loose or non-rigid foot. They are more prone to ankle sprain, but people with the high arch or normal arch, usually they have more rigid foot and they are not too prone to get ankle sprain. But as they said, as we said, they can get motoneuroma, or they can get plantar fasciitis, they can get bone spur on the heel, and all other problems that can happen in the foot. But in terms of ankle sprain, people that are flat foot, they more prone to ankle sprain. So if you are flat foot, for protecting yourself from injury, especially if you like the sport and you're into sport, make sure you do enough ankle strengthening every day. To protect your ankle from the ankle sprain, and make sure when you go to uneven surfaces you have a good shoes on and you have a good support. And if you already injured your ligament, you really want to be more careful and do a lot more exercises. Some people want to have a high top shoes, which is fine, that's protective because the ankle doesn't roll. But the problem with the high top shoes and using them all the time is your muscles in the ankle start getting lazier and they don't want to do anything. They said, oh, high top shoes is doing it for me, stabilizing it for me, why should I do that? And then you're going to start losing your muscle mass on the shin, and you're going to start losing your balance even more and more if you take the high top shoes off and you get dependent to that high top shoes. So high top shoes is a good idea just for short term, for people that they have acute ligament injury and they want to do sport. They might want to do it for a little while until the ligament gets stronger and then the muscle gets stronger by the exercises. And after they got stronger, they probably have to stop wearing that high top shoes, because then it's gonna get it more lazier and lazier. That's what I could tell you about the balance and ankle sprain. Basically, in next video, we're going to try to talk about gait and how the ankle problems can affect the walking. and what's the walking normal walking pattern and what's the abnormal walking pattern is, and you can, how you can correct that. Thank you for watching again, and have a great day.